Yeah, I'd like to defer my question to my brother here.
I'll grab the ball.
OCM Nishilicha, Nishilicha CM Chilton, Sinisnatan Chilton. I'm from here. We've been here since time immemorial, just to let you know. I want to recognize the Duwamish people, because their name was not said here in this house. So I want to know that's who ancestral bones we stand upon. We are related to the Duwamish OCM. So I have a question for you, Mr. Inslee. You know, you said that we're in control of our own destiny here in the state of Washington. And so why are we not taking bold steps to end liquefied natural gas, fracked gas? It's 80 times more toxic to the climate. We have a prophecy here. We all need to learn the prophecies where we stand upon the bones of the ancestors of the Duwamish. I'll share this prophecy with you shortly. It's very short. It said that these kulkali right here, these are kulkali, these are blackfish. These kulkali are ever to be absent from the waters here in our Shjana or Salish Sea. So will the humans be absent from the land. You are probably aware how many of these we have left. 77. And two just died. We don't have much time. Right now we need bold action. We need to be brave. We need to step up to the plate. We need to make a change for the children. I used to say that we're doing this for the grandchildren and the grandchildren beyond that, but I will not even say that anymore. I say we are only doing this for the children today. The world has changed that fast in this last summer. As you stated, all of those catastrophes that have happened, and we've witnessed those. So I ask you, what is your plan to end a 80 million gallon facility with a 3.5 mile blast zone that is illegally being put there without proper permits on the Puyallup's territory? What is your plan to do that if we're in control of our destiny here in the state of Washington? Then we need to have those bold steps. I ask you, what is your plan for that? And also, the one other question, we've got the government accountability office says that it's going to cost us $500 billion to deal with climate change by the end of this decade. How are we going to take care of that too?
A lot of important questions in that. It's a big question. You ask a really important question, I think, which is, what do we do about the fact at the moment that we have an economy that is dependent on some fossil fuels? What do we do about that fact? And that's a really important question, because the most aggressive thing we could do tomorrow is to eliminate the use of any fossil fuel tomorrow. That would be the most boldest, you ask for bold actions. That would be the most bold action we could take. We could say tomorrow it'll be illegal to use the internal combustion engine for a car, and you can't drive your car tomorrow. Just be efficient there. We could say we can eliminate all uses of liquid natural gas, and it is something we could do. I don't think most people are suggesting that. I don't think you're suggesting that. What we're looking for is the most rapid decarbonization of our economy that we can obtain. It is my belief that we have to have a deep decarbonization of our economy. And that includes weaning ourselves off of natural gas as we can, because natural gas does emit CO2 and it does emit methane. So it is a climate change gas. And my plan is, over time, to dramatically reduce liquid natural gas. Now, on the specific plants you're talking about, The permitting is done. The permits that are still under discussion are city and county permits. And I know you're going to be vocal to share your concerns with the city and county. These are largely not state permitting issues. They are city and county. Yep. So when I have a chance talking to the city and county, I'll make sure they know about your concerns, and I hope you will.
They know about it.
But I want to just finish on this one comment. I hope you have help on this. I know there's concerns about all kinds of plants here, the coal plant, there's a proposed oil and gas plant down in Vancouver. All of those would have to go through a permitting process. And I've been in a position to make sure that the law is followed, and the law will be followed on all of those. The only one that's been concluded to date is the coal plant, and that was not allowed to be permitted. Now these other plants, particularly the Vancouver plant, I am not capable to give you an answer to those because we have to finish the permitting process. So I can tell you we will have a robust evaluation. And on the climate plant, we're doing that right now. There's a review of the CO2 emissions and methane emissions upstream. It's going on right now. And when it finishes, then the right decisions will be made, although again, that's counting. So one other comment. We can't solve this just by saying, well, we can't build plants here. We gotta stop using this stuff. Ultimately, we gotta stop using liquid natural gas and oil. Ultimately, we have to do that. But we can't just say we're gonna solve it by saying, well, we just won't build it here, but we'll use it when it's manufactured in Oregon and Montana. Right now, we need electricity that comes from coal-fired plants in Montana. We can't continue to use electricity from Montana from coal-fired plants. We have to wean ourselves off of that. So we have to find a way to reduce the use of these products, and that's what my plan is, and we're going to accomplish it.
Please.
We don't have time. We'll talk to you. I know there's other people that I want to
listen to.
We don't have time for long-term plans. We do not have time for that. There are answers to LNG. You can use low carbon emitting diesel.
They're not wrong.
The laws on the
permanent path. I know how passionate you are feel about this issue. I'm going to look forward to getting to know you better over time. But I really want to take questions from people. So let's all ask people ask questions. I'm looking forward to that. Thanks.
Okay. Next, I have a hand up from one of our undergraduate students here. Okay, he there in the long hair and skirt.
My name is Fighting Woman, and I am the daughter of the Sea Monster Man. And I don't think that you understand that we don't have time. I don't think, when you say, you sound like we're talking about expansion and being weaned off. We don't need to wean off anything, we need to cut them off. We need to cut off PSC. They're not even an American company. We need to cut off LNG. We need to cut off coal. There is a way. You got the power. The power's in your hand. The people are behind you. We would lift you up. The Port of Tacoma is polluted, and you wanna allow the expansion of another facility and more poison into our Salish Sea. And what happens in Tacoma happens to Nisqually, happens to Tulalip, happens to Lummi. It happens to all of us. It happens to everyone that lives along the Salish Sea. What affects the land affects the water. What affects the water affects the land. And I know in your heart this is true. So why is it that we can't get you to say that you commit to not a long-term, but a short-term end to these kinds of facilities? We don't need them. We can cut them off. There is technology to cut them off. We are the evergreen state. And in 1805, when Lewis and Clark got here, you could walk across the river on top of the salmon. And by 1855, the salmon and the grizzly bear were being depleted. And by 162 years later, the governance of this state has they've screwed the Salmon Nations. And It's unacceptable to me. And why would you say that our environment's important and yet allow Atlantic salmon farm here? Yeah. Why is that? It's an invasive. It is not good for our environment. It is bad for our people. And our people have a sacred promise to this land. For millennia upon millennia, our people have taken care of this land, and the new people have not.
Thank you. So let me ask you a few questions. First off, I hope you will share your message with the legislature. I hope you will share the legislature message that you want to adopt policies that will reduce our usage of coal or eliminate it, that will reduce our usage of oil and gas and eliminate it. And I hope you'll support those measures this coming legislative session to reduce our usage of these products so they don't have to be made anywhere. Now here's the quandary as I see it, and it's a mutual quandary that we have. And again, it comes back to this issue. Are there any places in the world today that we should allow the use of liquid natural gas? Now that's a serious question that I ask. Is there anywhere in the world today that we should allow it to be used in any form? Or should we eliminate its use today and cut it all off? Here's the quandary. Here's the quandary that I think we have to think about. Are we going to eliminate the use of any plastic tomorrow? No, we aren't. People, I don't think anybody's suggesting that. But what people are suggesting is that we don't build an infrastructure that locks us in to a fossil fuel that would prevent the emergence of cleaner fuels like solar and wind. So when I look at this is, we should have policies that do not lock us into fossil fuels where there isn't some other renewable source to replace it. I'm going to come to the liquid gas plant, because this is an important question. First off, you've got to understand I'm not king, I'm only governor. And governors have to follow the law. The law is... The law is that the county and the city are the principal permitting agencies, not the state. So the issue is the county and the city on this. So that is the original permitting authority. So we need to follow the law on this. Now, there is something that I've been told.
Companies aren't following the law, sir. Tacoma isn't following
the law either.
I will be happy to review any permitting decisions, as will the courts. Now, there is one issue, just one other issue of liquid on this gas plant in Tacoma. I'm going to do some more work looking into this. In part, I brought this up. So I'm going to do a lot more looking into this to make sure that the state is following the law as they should. But I have been told, and I'm going to check to see if this is true or not, that this is a fueling station for ships servicing Alaska. And the ships servicing Alaska have to stop using bunker fuel because they're causing respiratory problems.
Right.
And under federal law, that they're required to stop using bunker fuel. So the question is, how are they going to run the ships? Can we do that on solar power? Can we do this on wind power? I don't think so, but we're trying to electrify our ferry fleet. I'm going to have my ferry fleets run on electricity so we don't have to use the dirty bunker fuel. Maybe someday they can use those ships and run them on vanadium batteries.
But
based on your question, I will find out the bottom of this. So we'll have more discussions about this. I'm happy to talk to you some more about it. Thank you.
Oh!
Well, I don't know.